Traveler, please, over here. It has been a while since you joined the Adventurers Guild. Are your adventures going smoothly? Is that so? Apart from your own skills, reliable teammates are also indispensable when adventuring. Another person to count on is always good after all. But recruiting such dependable companions is no easy matter, is it?
Yep, and it's even harder to get a guide as good as Paimon.
Ah, yes. I do have some information that may be of help to you. Let me consult our records. Ah, there it is. There's been a certain blonde stranger who arrived in Mondstadt lately, dressed in most unusual clothes.
Blonde. Dress is all funny. It feels like Paimon's heard this one before. Wait! Do you mean... Does that stranger's face look anything like his?
Like the honorary knights? No, they couldn't look more different. This stranger is a very tall man, and even has an eye patch.
Seriously? How does this have anything to do with Kaya? Eye patches can't prove that you're related anyway!
That stranger declined the guild's invitation, so I can't say that I know anything about the relationship between him and Mr. Kaya. Nonetheless, you can look for him if you're interested. Perhaps he might accept your commission instead. After all, it is not uncommon for some adventurers to not want to be limited by the guild, but be happy to accept a fellow adventurer's request. And should the stranger be a strong adventurer indeed, he would certainly be a big help on your journey. Please don't talk down on yourself like that. You are the honorary knight of the Knights of Favonius, after all. Your deeds are the stuff of song for all the bards in the city, even now. Well, as to further news about him, you may want to ask Mr. Lawrence. He stands guard at the city gate, so he may know something about that stranger. I wish you every success, adventurer.
Honorary knight. Is something the matter? A stranger with an eye patch. Let me think. Oh yeah, I remember seeing someone like that. A blonde stranger dressed in unusual garb. He was wandering all over Mondstadt at first, which I found rather suspicious. So I decided to keep an eye on him for a while. I lost him pretty quickly. Still, I didn't think that this was such a huge matter that we needed our outrider to pursue him by air. As long as Master Jean is here, there's nothing to fear from some suspicious, unusual-looking person.
That might be true, but if it were up to Jean, she'd take this way more seriously.
That is true. But on the other hand, knowing that Master Jean may overreact to the situation is all the more reason to not tell her, no? Anyways. Oh yeah, he was at Wagner's smithy for a while before I tried telling him. He might have said something to Wagner. You should go ask him. Maybe he has more news about our stranger.
What? You need something? Here. I remember him. He showed up a few days ago asking to buy a bunch of forging materials. Can't say I've heard of any of the materials he mentioned, though. He then had a look at the weapons in my shop before leaving. I've heard that he can be found drinking at the Angel's Share. If the Knights of the Guild want to get hold of him, that's the only place to be.
Angel's Share? Well, Master Diluc probably has his eye on that stranger too, then. Anyway, let's go to the Angel's Share and have a look.
Hard work is all there is to the craft.
Mm-hmm.
If I take it back, Allie, I should...
What will it be? Grape juice or apple cider?
Hey, Charles! Have you seen a blonde stranger who wears an eye patch around here by any chance?
That I have. He comes here every night. Just a drink, though. Doesn't order anything else. He even sometimes mixes his own drinks after he orders them. I don't know anything else about him, but from his selections and mixes, I'd say that he's quite the connoisseur.
And what's Master Diluc's opinion?
Why, I just gave it to you. Quite the connoisseur.
Investigating everything as always. Guess that's Diluc for you.
If you're looking for that gentleman, he ordered some new bottle of wine in advance yesterday. So he should be here today, too. There's too many raucous patrons on the first floor, so if you want to wait, best to go to the second. Ah, welcome, sir. The wine that you previously ordered is here.
He's really here? Let's go downstairs and have a look.
Hey, go on, drink some more.
No intention of paying us any mind, huh?
A traveler, you say? Why are you traveling? Well, that's as good a reason as any. Sit down over there, then.
So, guess we've broken the ice. What a weird guy.
That little one beside you.
Uh-huh! We're the best of friends!
It's indeed a good thing to have someone accompany you on your travels. My name's Dainsleif. I suppose you have some business with me? Sure.
And he was so cold just a moment before. Paimon's got a bad feeling about this.
But I will require advance payment. 500 mora, and 3 answered questions. The 500 is a one-time fee, and we'll settle the questions in a moment. That's it.
Well, now Paimon's got a really bad feeling. That kind of compensation can't be right.
Ah, thank you. Now, as for my questions, I'd like you to answer them here and now. The answer to a question says nothing about right and wrong, only about differences in attitude. I only wish to know what your choices are. Question 1. The crisis Mondstadt faced was resolved by an alliance between yourself and that Animo Archon who calls himself Venti. Who, in your view, was the key to ending that crisis? I know everything that I should. Well... answer the question. Is that your answer? I see. Question 2. Rex Lapis, who has defended Liyue Harbor for millennia on end, used his gnosis to lay down a contract to end all contracts, of which the stipulations are still unknown. Who do you think will defend Liyue Harbor in the future, now that they've lost their deity? So that's your answer? I see. Now for my final question. This world has people who gained visions and those who did not. Which of the two do you think hold more importance in the eyes of the gods? So, this is your answer then. I understand.
As I thought, you really are similar to her.
I'll take that 500 mora. And now I also understand your views on this world. As we agreed, you may now commission me. That said, I only take commissions related to the Abyss Order. Like you, I am currently on a journey. You intend to find your sibling, while I wish to oppose the Abyss. Ugh. Those creatures that serve the Abyss are the fangs and claws by which the Order spreads chaos in this world. I have come to Mondstadt this time while on the trail of an Abyss Herald.
An Abyss Herald?
An even more twisted abyssal being. One that commands the Abyss Mages.
Oh, that's right! We've just been fighting against the Fatui and Liyue, who are human too! We haven't encountered the non-human Abyss Order at all!
There's some reason behind that, I'm afraid. It's possible that they may have been under orders to redirect your path.
Oh, that does sound pretty dangerous. Maybe they're looking for a better time to ambush us or something. Uh-huh, we're super duper strong!
That manor, it's just like hers. Well then, let's go see for ourselves, shall we? According to the leads I have on hand, the Abyss Order has re-infiltrated the Temple of the Falcon. Let's meet up at the temple. Perhaps your questions about the Abyss will be answered there. This abandoned temple does bear some marks of the Abyss. The Falcon of the West. Though it can soar in the wind, it ultimately does naught but hover under the light of the gods. Oh, it's nothing. Let's head inside.
My demon-expelling mantra is ready!